looking at advanced God-Eater tactics and awareness. This could save your life out in the field. Mid-sized and larger Aragami are often made of sterner stuff. They have armor of different thickness about their bodies. By watching for their response immediately following an attack, you can tell if you're striking an effective area. There are four possible responses from a God Arc attack. This shows them ordered from weakest to strongest. Be sure to watch for these replies when you strike Aragami. Always focus your attacks where they are most effective. I've prepared a Vajra simulation target. Go ahead and begin combat. Try to discover where all responses land. Are exceedingly weak, while their capes will deflect almost any attack thrown at them. Striking against those points is almost useless. It's always better to shift position and adjust your specific target. Now, an Aragami's armor can change as well. Anything from activation to bond breaks can affect its strength.
Eat this! Eat this!
With this particular training target, a bond break will weaken the defense of its head and forelegs. Do note, however, that sometimes shattering an Aragami bond will create armor elsewhere. Observation is key here. Also bear in mind that different weapons are more or less effective against various body parts. Another preferred method is to attack with elemental powers. When you find an enemy weak to blaze, freeze, spark, or divine attacks, you can exploit these breaks to bring them down. Once again, you'll know for certain if an element is effective by watching for the Aragami's response. Now, using everything you've learned today, slay this target.
Eat this!
Try out whatever elemental attacks you can get your hands on. Take advantage of these weaknesses. Striking with increased force and efficiency will change your battles to the core. The very heart of this is simple. When you're in the field, trust in your natural style of combat. Experiment and learn. That is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Dismissed, God Eater.
Looks like we're heading out together this time, huh? I'm glad we made it this far. At the end of the day, surviving is what matters in this line of work. I think I've got to be extra careful. I don't know what my mom and sister would do if I... Well, never mind. Oh, hey, on the down low, do you know Sakuya? Yeah? Are you close? Isn't she just smoking hot? And not just hot, but kind. And sweet. And hot! She's like a freaking Amazon warrior maiden. Damn, she's so fine. Even just thinking about her has got me all hyped for another mission. How about a little contest? Let's see which of us takes down the most origami. Oh, she'll be all over me then. Yeah.
Your primary target today is called a Kongo, a medium-sized origami with devastating power. It won't just deal out punishment, but it can also take a beating before it goes down. It's the strongest enemy you've faced. Make sure you've brought supplies and be careful to use them intelligently. Come home safe.
Time to get busy, baby! Yeah!
Take them down!
Nope, definitely.
The origami is retreating.
Where the hell are you going? Hey!
It's over already. Nice. The mission's not done yet. Okay, well, it's technically done. Just keep watch.
Good job, team. Let's head on home. It's almost dinner time.
I can't wait to see you all safe and sound. You did so wonderfully today.
Let's begin with a concept, arcology. In essence, a building completely self-contained, but that's not all. Self-sufficient as well, both in production and consumption therein. Of course, the best example is here. The Fenrir Far East branch, with the den at its core, is an arcology. In any situation, no matter how extreme, we could survive alone, even should all the remaining Fenrir structures collapse. Our status as an arcology would ensure that we could live on just as before. Still eat, work, and fight, all based on our own production. Beneath the den is a fully equipped plant that produces food, god arcs, and any needed material for the people of the branch. Atop all that, we are supremely defensive. An anti-origami wall lines the perimeter, and we boast the strongest god-eaters squadrons. That, in a nutshell, is the Far East. A powerful and complex arcology, optimized solely for the protection of humankind. Unfortunately, we are still plagued by a number of issues. Foremost among them is that we simply cannot house all our citizens. I am certain you've seen the vast outer ghetto, a collection of ramshackle housing that lies just beyond the core of the branch. We would love to have those people inside, but the fact is, we simply don't have the room to accommodate. I'm afraid that the best we can do now is surround that ghetto with a larger anti-origami wall. Options are limited.
I don't know if that's enough. The armor's been breached a whole lot lately. Never bad, but still.
Which is precisely why we have the defense unit stationed there, our strongest shield. Oh, goodness me, you were born in the outer ghetto, weren't you, Coda? My apologies. I did not mean to dismiss your fear so lightly.
Oh, no. It's not a problem.
Actually, there was a plan to expand the interior of the den. We were going to build another layer down for new residents.
But it never came through. The Aegis project picked up. And that's supposed to make us all much safer anyways.
Well, yes, exactly. At this time, a massive majority of Far East resources and the underground plant are being dedicated to helping construct the Aegis. But I think that should be a topic for another time.
I thought I was done learning, but maybe that's just an old fool talking. I thought I was done learning, but maybe that's just an old fool talking.
Next mission is gonna be a breeze. This feeling is incredible. The power is begging to be set free.
If it kills quicker,